Hello, my name is Matush. I'm going to introduce you to the EDAM ontology and also BioXFD, which are two independent projects, but the overlap of people working on those two is quite huge. So that's why both. And Toshiaki was interested in to hear about both as well. So first, the EDAM ontology. EDAM stands for Embrace Data and Methods Ontology because it has been developed within the Embrace project. So that's not so important anymore. If they're actually thinking about renaming it Bioinformatics Data Method Ontology or something like that. In any case, it's an ontology for annotation of bioinformatics tools and resources, data in general. These are the people who've been working on it. The principles of EDAM, in addition to that, it is not application specific. But its development has been use-case-driven, but not use-case-specific either. The content, however, should be bioinformatics-specific, with few exceptions. We have a well-defined scope, so exactly saying that we want to model bioinformatics operations, types of data, which includes identifiers, topics within bioinformatics, and data formats. EDAM must be relevant and usable, otherwise it does not make sense. So it must be useful for the users, and it must be usable for the annotators as well. It must be logically healthy or ontologically sane, with well-defined concepts and reflecting the reality as it is. And it must be maintainable in a small team of people so that we can keep on developing it. The scope of EDAM is topics related to bioinformatics, such as, for example, phylogenetics or protein classification or systems biology. Then operations, that those are the things which take an input and give an output, or associate input with an output, depends whether you look at it procedurally or declaratively. And those are, for example, multiple sequence alignment or molecular dynamics simulation, those kind of things. Types of data, for example, sequence trace or sequence record, position frequency metrics, UniProt accession or ensemble gene ID, all those are types of data. And formats of data such as FASTA, FASTQ, SPNL, BioXSD. RDF, of course. So these are the covered ones, are the four main sub-ontologies of EDAM, the operation, topic, data, and format. Identifier is another sub-ontology, which actually is part of data, and there are some relations maintained within EDAM, between the concepts. There are a couple of more relations or properties, psychology, and which are defined in EDAM but are maintained between the concepts. This is how an example annotation with EDAM may look, which is a case of annotating a tool or a package. So the tool or a collection of tools may have a topic, such as, for example, systems biology. And the tool or its operations may have a function, for which you can then use term or concept from EDAM from the operation sub-ontology, and they may have inputs and outputs, which are some types of data, and those inputs and outputs have a format, which is as well modeled in EDAM. Now, BioXSD. BioXSD is an effort for making a common XSD based XML exchange format for basic bioinformatics data. So the goals are to be an XSD based XML format because we think that it's important to support all XSD based formats and RDF and some reasonable plain text formats, especially the tabular ones. It's like people in Japan understand that it's important to have both good roads and good railways and good airports. That's why we think it's good to have good RDF formats and good XML formats and good textual formats. gap between the other specialized XSP-based formats, such as SPML, file XML, all the similar ones. It's compatible with the XML libraries, the existing simple XML libraries for all the main programming languages, so that we don't have to give binding to all the programming languages to make people, to enable people using it. The idea is to keep it as lightweight as possible, but fitting everyone to enable it serving as a canonical data model, which of course can be conflicting requirements, but we want to find a good middle layout. Yeah, and actually has been developed and maintained in an open collaboration, which should be organized, but of course welcoming input from the community. And we need to have it, and we have a detailed structure which enables in the validation of the data, semantic annotation, which is done, for example, with the data ontology, and efficient compression, for example, with the new XSIG standard. So, XSD is an XSD-based format for sequences, alignments of sequences, sequence and genome features, which includes any kind of ontology annotation by any ontologies. So the idea of XSD is to have common XSD, but being able to use any ontologies that you would want, or not just ontologies, any enumerated information from the semantic web. And it contains also some other accessory types for references, for example, accessions and other small types of data. And these are the links to remember. So the first two are for the data ontology and biosity.org. And the Dr. Guide at SourceForgeNet, that's a catalog of bioinformatics databases which are annotated with enum.